Hey, what's up guys, welcome back. You're watching for today. OxygenOS 16 stable version is available for OnePlus 13, and soon we will get the stable OxygenOS 16 for OnePlus 12 series in the first week of November 2025. But I already in-depth reviewed almost each and every single feature of OxygenOS 16 with the series of different videos. We'll find those video links in the description. Today we are back again with review of the new OxygenOS 16 Game Assistant, which is completely revamped and offers lots of amazing features that were not present in old OxygenOS 15 Game Space application. The most wanted special feature, bypass charging, is now available for OnePlus 12R, which was not working in OxygenOS 15. So don't skip any part of this video. I thoroughly reviewed each and every small changes of this application and its new feature that will drastically improve your gaming experience. I always try to provide genuine content after thorough reviews, so please press like and hype button, which will ultimately help me to grow our channel. Now without further delay, let's get started. We will compare side by side OxygenOS 15 Game Space, which is available on my OnePlus Nord 5, versus new OxygenOS 16 Game Assistant, which is available on my OnePlus 12R. On OxygenOS 16, this application version is updated to the new Game Assistant 10.17 Infinity, while on OxygenOS 15, it has the old Game Application version 5.24. If we compare both of these applications side by side, you will find the new user interface of new OxygenOS 16 Game Assistant, which is completely different. The new Game Assistant has all the games or non-gaming applications which are added to the Game Assistant. They will be available on the top side, horizontally and vertically. New plus icon is available. By using that, you can add any user application available on your device into Game Assistant. In the new OxygenOS 16 Game Assistant, by using the performance setting, we can even change all the performance settings for specific applications individually. While in old OxygenOS 15, Game Space application have some useless steps at the bottom. Also, we are not able to change performance mode separately for different applications. Only one-time setup of game features will be applicable for all applications. On the left side, 3-dot menu setting of the OxygenOS 16 Game Assistant, we get some old and new features. Under Game Capture, we get all the screenshot and screen recordings of all games. By just horizontal swiping, we can switch between all applications and can check all the screen recordings and screenshot taken for respective applications separately. In OxygenOS 15, all of these are combined together in one Game Capture option. OxygenOS 15 has game data option, which shows total screen on and user's time for all gaming applications in Game Space, but this option is not available in OxygenOS 16 version. Under more setting of Game Assistant, there are new automatic RAM optimization and adjustment of the screen resolution are available, which are not available in old OxygenOS 15 Game Space. But OxygenOS 15 Game Space offers some filters like HDR, night vision, brightening and old mode, which are not available in new Game Assistant of OxygenOS 16. In new Game Assistant, you can customize the performance mode setting and can apply them separately to specific applications. Performance modes like power saving, balance and pro gamer modes are available similar like OxygenOS 15. But under Display tab, we get the new Hyper HDR, and under Control tab, we also get the new Hyper Response Engine. For Hyper Response Engine, we can change the touch position and swipe sensitivity using slider controls. Here we get an animated sample to show demo of how the touch responsiveness will be improved when this engine is on and when it's off. We also get the new Ultra Touch under the Touch Response option, which is not available in old Game Space of OxygenOS 15. Network and focus settings have all the same old features. GPU setting also provides the same old Mesa anisotropic filtering and texture filters. Remember, the GPU settings are only accessible via more option in new Game Assistant. Its separate shortcut tab will not be available in the floating bar. Now we'll check out the floating window of new game assistant was old game space. The new game assistant has a new animation for game FPS and network. New game assistant has four shortcuts on the left side panel for performance, tools, game assistant setting and applications. While old game space has only two shortcuts like applications and game setting. All other shortcuts of game assistant have new square dials while old one has rectangular shape. The new game assistant has new animation when you switch between performance modes. We also get the quick shortcuts for Hyper HDR, touch response, etc. which are not available in old game space. Old OxygenOS 15 game space floating window offers touch optimization, but it's not as advanced as new game assistant. So finally, OnePlus added bypass charging for OnePlus 12R in OxygenOS 16. Who gets the new tab for bypass charging, similar to old OxygenOS 15 for supported devices. You just need to connect the charger, enable the bypass charging toggle, then set the bypass charging percentage level to trigger bypass. This means if you set the bypass charging at 80%, it will trigger when your device charging reaches to 80%. Then device charging will stop and it starts to supply power only for gaming application. The new game assistant has new game voice changer which offers separate male and female voice configurations along with different voice types. While in OxygenOS 15 only voice types are available. GPU customization tab is available in OxygenOS 15 game space, which is not available in the new game assistant. You can only change it using GPU setting option available in the more settings of new game assistant. New game assistant system status floating bar have new animations when you expand or minimize it, while the old system status is simple one. Some shortcut tabs are new on OxygenOS 16 game assistant like LAN, Hello Audio to quickly enable Hello Audio for games by enabling the single quick toggle. We also get the bullet notification tile in a game assistant. OxygenOS 15 automatic adjustment of resolution didn't support the BGMI or some other games. But in OxygenOS 16 game assistant, in a more setting, this option toggle is available and working for all the games. OxygenOS 15 game space offers OnePlus feature called as footsteps sound boost for games like BGMI, but it's not available in new OxygenOS 16 game assistant. In the new game assistant, we again got the new feature in a network optimization to manually scan Wi-Fi network by turning your device clockwise, which detects the location where you gauge the maximum strength of your network. Whereas in OxygenOS 15, no such advanced settings are available. Finally, I played BGMI on new OxygenOS 16 with new features of game assistant like Hyper HDR, Hyper Response Engine, Ultra Touch, etc. Game FPS was stable throughout the gameplay. It's running very smooth and touch response is also very good. So definitely the new game assistant and its features are really useful to boost your gaming experience on new OxygenOS 16. I also tried the new bypass charging on my OnePlus 12R. It was working, but one bug I noticed is that when I tried to use it, the device started to heat and game FPS dropped to 60 FPS. I think OnePlus should check this issue and please fix this as soon as possible. So this is all over for today guys. Hope you got clear idea how powerful OxygenOS 16 game assistant is, which offers lots of new features along with new bypass charging for OnePlus 12R. If you liked our work, then please do like and share this video, subscribe to our channel, press the bell icon for notifications of our upcoming content related to OnePlus and OxygenOS. Thanks for watching. See you next time. Take care. Bye-bye.